from a Dajjal. You can say it in every given supplication that you're making. But here it is something that is to show that it is a part of the salah. طيب. And that's the point we wanted to make. So he mentioned, يَقُومَ أَحَدُهُمْ يُصَلِّ فَيُصَلِّ. He said, a person will stand up and he will pray. وَيُزَيِّنُ صَلَاتُهُ لَمَّا يَرَى مَنْ مِنْ نَظَرِ رَجُلٍ إِلَيْهِ. He said, a person will, meaning people will stand in salah, or some of them will stand in salah, and he will beautify his salah when he realized that someone was looking at him. And this is what the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام mentioned. This hadith أخرجه Imam Ahmad وابن ماجة وحاكم والحاكم وصححه حاكم وحسنه شيخ الألباني رحمه الله. A person will stand up in a prayer. Upon knowing that someone else is seeing him, now he starts beautifying his salah. Is there anybody that feels safe from this? That's why the Shaykh Hafidhullah, the next line he say, فَهَذَا قَدْ يَقَعَ مِنَ الْمُسْلِمْ وَالْمُؤْمِنِ. And this can happen to a Muslim and to someone higher than him, a mu'min. Alright? This can happen to a Muslim. It can happen to someone higher of a level, which is a mu'min. This is why fighting for ikhlas is a eternal, it is a ongoing non-stop fight against oneself. Jihadun nafs. Fighting against your own soul. So what you are doing, you do not put nobody in it from the creation. You don't include no one in your actions but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning there is no one that you will give a share in your action. No one. All of your action is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now tell me. Tell me, barakallahu feekum. Kullun ala shakilatihi. That everyone upon their level. Tell me who is not fighting this fight. Who is not fighting this fight? Except one that is, that feels safe from al-nifaq. This was this well-known statement of the Salaf. La ya'man ani nifaq illa munafiqun khalus. Wa la yakhsha ani nifaq illa mu'min. No one feels safe from hypocrisy except a true believer, except a hypocrite. No one feels safe from hypocrisy except a hypocrite. But no one fear for hypocrisy except a believer. Remember, when Umar radiallahu anhu, when he went to Hudhaifa, when he mentioned to Hudhaifa, أَذَكَرَنِي, did the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made a mention of my name among the hypocrites? Allahu Akbar. Akhi, from the Umar radiallahu anhu, if we were to talk about his virtue, you will know without a doubt that he is not a hypocrite. You will know that he is not a hypocrite. Just like the hadith that we studied yesterday, right? That we mentioned yesterday. Anybody remember the hadith? Abu Ibrahim? Right, lama sa'ida ala Uhud. Right, ahsanta. If that was him, I would give you a hard time. Now, so when the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was on the Mount of Uhud, and the Mount of Uhud starts shaking, And the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam told him, Uskun ya Uhud. Oh, you Uhud, calm down. Because someone, meaning those who are on the top of you, is a prophet, a Siddiq, and two martyrs. He said, cool off, calm down, keep calm. Because on the top of you is a prophet, a Siddiq, Abu Bakr, and the two Shaheed, meaning Abu Umar and Uthman. So here it is a tazkiyah that the messenger gave to Umar ibn al-Khattab. That is sarahatan, clear, very clear. No ambiguity whatsoever. No mutashabihat whatsoever. And from the ashara, al-mubashirina bil jannah, from those 10 that was granted the jannah while they were alive, Umar ibn al-Khattab is to be mentioned after Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. When the messenger mentioned about Umar, if he passed by one street, that the shaitan will take another street. But with all of this, fuduliyya, yakhsha ala nafsihi, yakhafu ala nafsihi min al-nifaq. He fear for himself about hypocrisy. He fear for himself about hypocrisy. He fear for himself about falling into those that the messenger alayhi salatu wasalam has given their name to who? To Hudhayfa radiyallahu anhu wa arda. So who among us, barakallahu fikum, doesn't have this fear in them? About I fear that perhaps I'm having riya in how I'm doing it because, and this is what he say, فَقَدْ يَقَعَ. This indeed happened min al-Muslim, and likewise min al-Mu'min. This can possibly happen to somebody, he is a Muslim. He submitted, and also to a believer, a Mu'min, who has a daraja that is higher. But here is the question. The Shaykh didn't mention Muhsin. He didn't mention Muhsin. And we know the maratibul deen is thalatha, al-Islam, wal-Iman, wal-Ihsan. Why didn't he mention to the mu'min, to the muhsin? Right, that's the definition of a muhsin. But he said, why here did the Shaykh didn't mention the Muhsin? لماذا? Yeah, Ihsan is the most complete level of the religion. Naam, Abdullah. I'm sorry? No, that's not answering this. Yes, كل محسن مؤمن. Yes, that's true. But here, look, kullu Muslim, kullu mu'min, Muslim. But yet he mentioned both of them. But here, why didn't he mention the Muhsin? Abdullah, I'm coming at you. You owe me 2 yesterday. I didn't forget. I owe you. Na'am, faddal Aba Ibrahim. Ahsanallah ilayk. That is true. That's the last daraja. But why? Limadha? Hassan. How many minutes we got out? Abu Fatima, ma indak?
The ihsan, you worship Allah like you seen it. It's no riya in it when you get to La Marata.
You will say that, yes. Because when a person has ihsan, he is not involving no one else in the picture. As our brother mentioned, the definition of the muhsin is أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه. It's just that you have in front of you Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. And you don't know, you don't see Allah, but know that Allah is seeing you. So this individual, he know that Allah is seeing him. And this is how he is worshiping Allah. Not that Abdullah or Abdurrahman or Uthman or Abdullah are looking at him. La, but he knows that Allah is seeing him. وَهَذَا يَكْفِيهِ This is enough for him. This is enough for him. This is enough for him. Because he does worship Allah based on these two. Like he sees Allah in front of him, or because he knows that Allah is seeing him. And this is his concentration. This is what his concentration. Allah is seeing me. He is not putting no one else's sight in this issue. So he says, فَإِذَا وَجَدَ فِي نَفْسِهِ شَيْئًا Now here, listen to this point and we'll conclude with this. So all of us could be subjected to this. All of us could be having this amrad. All of us could have this sickness. None of us are free from this sickness. None of us free from this sickness of being wanted to be heard or being seen. Right? He mentioned, فَإِذَا وَجَدَ فِي نَفْسِهِ شَيْئًا مِنْ هَذَا الرِّيَاءِ قَاوَمَهُ وَدَعَى إِلَىٰ الْإِخْلَاصُ لِلَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ وَعَادَ إِلَىٰ إِخْلَاصِ اللَّهِ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى فَلَا يَضُرُّهُ إِذَا دَفَعَهُ جَزَاكَ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا The Shaykh Hafidhullah, he say, if anyone see in him some type of riyah, he say he will strive to repel it. He will strive to repel it and defend it and block it. وَعَادَ إِلَىٰ إِخْلَاصِ لِلَّهِ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى And then he will immediately return to having sincerity for Allah alone. Right? If it is coming to you, you blocking it, you repelling it, and then you allow yourself to return, wa'ada, and he returned back to the ikhlas of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now he feels like he's having a little bit of, you know, wanting to show the brother, I get a little bit of things under my belt. Now he will repel it right away. In return to Alhamdulillah, why am I doing this for this individual that will die? And my reward is not in his hands. And I should concentrate in my Lord, because indeed he is the one that will retribute me. And if I give him any share of my action will be done. Now that will cause him to come back to what? To that which the Shaykh Hafidhullah he mentioned. He say, قَاوَمَهُ وَعَادَ إِلَىٰ إِخْلَاصِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ So if he repel it and he returned back to ikhlas, فَلَا يَضُرُّهُ إِذَا دَفَعَهُ It will not harm him anymore if he block it. Now the riyah is entering, right? It is entering. Now if he blocks it, then it's not going to be harmful for him no more. وَأَمَّا إِذَا اسْتَمَرَّ He say, but if it continues ma'ahu with him, فَإِنَّهُ يُبُطِلْ al-amal, It will destroy his actions. If he does not fight that riyah with him, if he doesn't fight it, to repel it, to control it and return back to the ikhlas, but rather he let it continue, he let it flow, he say that it will destroy that action. He say, إِذَا كَانَ ma'ahu, If he has with him, Min ash, min bidayatihi. If he has, idha kana ma'ahu, min bidayatihi, the action that he has from the beginning. It will destroy it, wal'iyadhu billah. Wa kathalika, likewise. Idha tara fi athna al-amal, wa stamarra ala al-rajih, he say, but likewise, if the person has in the beginning, meaning in the middle of the action, that which is yani the riyah, and he continue with it, and this is in regard to what is the yani the arrajih, meaning the most strongest issue in here, that the action would be based upon what? Upon riyah. Because a person can start an action with ikhlas, completely ikhlas. He can be by himself in the masjid, right? And he start praying. He is not showing off for nobody. Because there is nobody to show off. You were the only one in the masjid. But in the middle of the action, in the middle